It's really loud in here. However, I'm at the roaster and I found a bag of roasted barley. Let's check it out.
Being the oldest malting plant in Belgium means we make a lot of different kinds of malt, which is fantastic for making award-winning beers. However, sometimes brewers still have a hard time understanding how they are to be used. Don't worry, we've got you covered. In this series, we show you how to use each and every single one of all of our malts.
Yeah, so like I said, I've got a bag of roasted barley with me. Now, when you talk about roasted barley, this is probably one of the oldest malts, colored malts, that are produced. And as the name suggests, it's not malted. It's literally just barley that's been roasted. Let's go back to the lab, see exactly what's going on with this malt, and let's get to some usage suggestions, which some you might not have thought of.
Roasted barley is exactly as the name implies. Raw barley that is roasted to a particular finish. Our roasted barley is made at 230 degrees Celsius to ensure maximum roasted qualities without harshness. The signature ingredient in stouts particularly, it has more complex roast flavor profile than darker speciality malts and produces the lightest colored foam as compared to all other roasted type malts.
Our roasted barley n'est pas un réel malt parce qu'il n'a pas été germé, donc c'est de l'orge qui a été torréfié directement sur le tambour de torréfaction. Et donc on va monter ici jusqu'à 1200 EBC et cette coloration va permettre d'amener des arômes de torréfaction tout à fait différents du malt black, idéal pour des stouts, des bières très noires.
Belgian beers, Trappist style double. When you simply want to adjust for color, especially in that warm mahogany red range, this specialty ingredient is perfect. If you plan on only using mid-range caramels as a flavor basis, and either light or amber syrup, look at using between 0.5 to 2% roasted barley for that perfect color without making the beer roasty. Belgian Quadrupel. Here we want color as well as a dry finish, which roasted barley is well suited to do. To really pin down that dry finish in perception, ensure you have a good level of attenuation from the yeast, and use approximately 2 to 4% roasted barley in the recipe. British beers, stouts, all of them. There are many differences between stouts and other dark beers, but the use of roasted barley sits squarely at the top of the list. Here we suggest not exceeding 10% in the recipe, as well as making sure there is enough carbonates in the brewing water to account for the acidity of the grain. Brown ales. As a way of adding color and complexity to the final product, use between 1.5 and 3% of the recipe. German beers. Rauchbier. As both a color and flavor enhancer, a bit of roasted barley is a natural choice to add complexity to the smoky character of the smoked malts. Use 3 to 5% in the grist. American beers. California Common. If you are particularly worried about the color of the foam here, swap out the dark roasted malts for 1 to 2% roasted barley. At this level, your beer color will be correct for the style, the foam will be very light, and you will have only the slightest hint of complexity in the malt profile.